Hello there, it is I, the Geordie Nerd, and I am back again with another episode of BoJack Horseman Season 3, Episode 5. Thank you for your patience, it's been a rough time, but I'm not going to get into all that. Link is down below if you would like to see the full unedited reaction. I do know that some of the reactions are missing on Patreon, that was because they were taken down. And unfortunately, I had to reformat my hard drive, so unfortunately they're not coming back. I do apologize. I'm going to invest in some extra HDD drives or whatever you call them to store things on just in case that happens again. But I appreciate your support and your patience. Let's just get into this now and have some fun.
Wouldn't it be weird if literally nobody saw your movie?
How do I get out of this conversation?
Just think, by this time tomorrow we'll know if it's a hit or a flop.
Todd, stop helping.
BoJack, the East Coast box office is in.
Secretariat is, wait for it,
a huge success.
Why would you make me wait for it? That was a terrible time for a wait for it.
Do you know what this means? You're no longer just some TV actor they threw into a movie.
You're a bona fide movie, wait for it, star.
Wow, okay. I mean, technically it wasn't him. It's CGI, but wow, maybe?
I think you are great.
Oh.
Is that all?
I'm sorry. I'm not always good at using words to describe emotions.
You're making me crazy right now. Come on. I mean, I understand from her point of view, but I also do understand from his because, you know, she was back in the country and didn't say anything for, well, a long time. But also at the same time, he was very, I don't want to say controlling, but in a way kind of was. She hated like surprise parties, yet he still went ahead and gave her one, even though he knew. And just the way he words things around her, I mean, I don't know if it's just me picking up on that, but it just seems very manipulative and controlling. But he's the nice guy, if that makes sense.
So you have a night off tonight.
A night off? When's the last time that happened?
It hasn't. Can I help you with anything else?
Yeah, you can get me a date for tonight. Actually, make that 3 dates. Who knows when I'm gonna get another night off?
I do, and you won't.
Epic beard, my dude.
What brings you here?
My dumb best friend's getting married, so I'm here for the rehearsal dinner.
Why is everybody not talking about me for a moment? This is very concerning.
Oh my god, you're BoJack Horseman.
Yeah, duh.
I loved the BoJack Horseman show. That is like my favorite show.
You mean horsing around?
No, the BoJack Horseman show. It was so dumb. It was the best.
Thank you.
I mean, it was the worst, but that's what made it so good, you know?
Yeah.
I once worked for somebody, and I won't say their name, but if you weren't talking about them, they would literally walk away. Mid-conversation, like, this is of no interest to me, and walk away. And one time, he actually said, well, if he's on talking about me, he's have to get back to work. I don't understand that.
I just got a text from Alexi Brosafino.
The famous movie star and man about town?
He wants me to come to his house and party with his friends.
The Snatch Batch? Alexi Brosafino wants you to party with the Snatch Batch?
He's one of our clients. I met him a couple weeks ago and we talked about me Instagramming one of his parties. I didn't think he actually wanted me to do it tonight.
Oh, wait, tonight? I was hoping we could snuggle up on the couch and watch Bones.
I don't think that show's about what you think it's about. Besides, I have to go. It's for work.
She's playing with her hair there. Isn't that like one of those universal love languages where you find someone attractive, you're just playing with your hair? It's a good thing I don't have long hair because I'd be playing with it now because I'm a handsome son of a gun. Not at all. Don't even believe that myself.
Buenas noches, amigos. Let's get blasted. Right?
Oh my god. BoJack Horseman, the movie star. This is the happiest day of my life.
I mean, it looks like his daughter is getting married, but yeah, okay, you've met a person who sits and talks on a camera. It must be riveting excitement for you.
Who's that?
Holy shit, is that a Klimt?
Hey guys, we got a guest. Diane, this is Carlos, David, and Shit Show.
Yo,
word.
Ah, the famous Snatch Batch.
Oh, that's just like a dumb name some reporter came up with.
We don't actually call ourselves that.
Yeah, we all have sex with a lot of women, but who cares?
Hey, we also love getting brunch. Hey, you might as well call us the Brunch Batch.
Or the
Dave Franco. Yes, that's who it is.
When you know, you know. You know? So congrats to the happy couple for knowing. Okay, as they say in the movie business, That's a wrap on BoJack. Let's hear it from some of these bridesmaids.
Well, I mean, at least he didn't say anything inappropriate and horrible. I mean, give it time. He might be, drunk in 5 minutes.
Oh, you know what would solve a lot of problems? If there was a rideshare app for women that only had women drivers.
That is such a good idea, Todd. You always did have such great ideas.
You know what else would be cool? A miniature cupcake gun, so you could shoot tiny cupcakes into your mouth. Uh-oh, is that guy trying to kill himself? Nope, just a cupcake gun.
Wait.
I'd like to invest. Not in the rideshare one. That sounds ridiculous. Give me the mini muffin gun. Cupcake gun. Whatever. Same thing.
Tell you what, I'd be happy to put you in the stirrups and take a look at the old cat eggs.
Ugh, not if you were the last albino rhino gyno on the planet.
And also, dude, come on, that's not dinner talk, is it?
I was thinking about what BoJack said before, about how when you know, you know, and I'm sitting there and I'm thinking, do I know? I mean, I think I know. But if you know when you know and I only think that I know, maybe that means that I don't know, right?
Oh boy.
Karen, I'm sorry. I love you, but I can't do this. The wedding's off.
Oh shit.
It's a rehearsal dinner.
Thank you, BoJack.
Wow. Thank you, BoJack. I mean, technically, he just said something nice. And she took it in a different way. So is this BoJack's fault? Yes. Yes, it is.
We're hanging out together and we're having a good time, so just come back inside.
Everyone knows I don't belong there.
Hey, you belong wherever you want to belong, Diane.
Yeah?
Yeah. Look at me. I'm a handsome white guy and I never feel like I don't belong.
Oh, that's horrible. But also, I think maybe the drugs might have started kicking in now. Not 100% sure. I need to look at the evidence a bit longer, but I'm 50% sure.
I could use a bite to eat, though. You know, there's this great place around the corner. It's a little hole in the wall, but they do a nice cheese plate.
I was going to say, can cats eat cheese? But yes, they can. And I saw something in a vet that, like, 3 blocks of cheese is, like, the equivalent of 2 cheeseburgers to a cat. Like, damn.
I want to go in the hotel room and fool around. Do you?
I don't know, Emily. You're pretty drunk.
No, I'm not. I'm not drunk at all.
Oh.
No, I might have said this before. I'm not 100% sure. But I don't see him, Todd, as like a sexual person, if that makes sense. At first, I thought maybe he was gay. But now I don't know. How do I say it? He comes across as very childlike and innocent, and I don't think sex is something that he's all that interested in.
I should just settle?
Yes, thank you. Exactly, settle. Because otherwise, you're just going to get older and harder and more alone. And you're going to do everything you can to fill that hole with friends and your career and meaningless sex. But the hole doesn't get filled. And one day, you're going to look around and you're going to realize that everybody loves you. But nobody likes you. And that is the loneliest feeling in the world.
I mean, I don't think you should settle for somebody. If you don't have feelings for them, I think you should move on. Because it's not fair on you or that person. But I do get the need to want someone to love you and take care of you and all those things. But again, you shouldn't just be with someone for that reason. For your needs. The needs should be met. It's a partnership. You should go into it loving and caring for each other and want to make that person better. And yeah, it's a tough one. I mean, I don't know. I'm friggin' useless at all that love stuff, clearly. So just do what you want, right? Christ.
No, don't worry. Your baby's fine.
What do you mean, baby? Why do you say baby?
Do you not know? You're pregnant.
Holy nips. Yeah, I was going to say that the bones, it did sound like Emily Deschanel. But Diane is pregnant. Holy fork. Holy shit. I'm not in the good place. Why can't I swear? Holy fuck. That is crazy. Okay. Wow. It's Mr. Peanut Butters, right? It's not going to come out. It's somebody else's. Jesus Christ. I'm actually shocked. I didn't expect that. Is the baby going to come out high? Was the baby high? I have questions. Wow. Thank you very much for your patience. I really do appreciate it. I know it takes a long time to get these out. But if you're on Patreon, you're getting three in a row. And I'm going to try and maintain that until the show is done. Thank you for your support. I really do appreciate it. You're all awesome. And again, I appreciate it. I really do. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all again very soon for more BoJack Horseman reaction videos.